Now, this great venue has hosted some memorable playoff games over the years, and these Bear fans are hoping to make some new memories today at Soldier Field in Chicago. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Detroit Lions and the Chicago Bears. One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. And Goff going to look to throw right away. And right away, he lost the football. And this is picked up by the Bears. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
As you and I both know, one reason teams sprint plays to start a game is so they can practice them ahead of time. I will guarantee you, that fumble was not in the script.
You don't think they had fumble written next to play one there?
No, that was never in the script because they want to have good memories when they go into a ball game, not something that could have gone wrong.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
From the 24, Allen. Open man is Samuel, complete. And he's brought down, but he has it down to the 12. Only a pickup of 12, first and 10.
Doesn't matter whether it's zone coverage or man coverage, the dropback can be effective when it's running well.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. In motion goes the tight end. Running straight ahead is Jacobs. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Best receivers have spread the defense out, and they're able to come through with a slash and run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
A good run got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. They run behind center with Gainwell. And he'll only get a yard to bring up 3rd and 1.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up 3rd and 2. Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And they needed 2. They could only get 1. 4th down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
They go with Jacobs, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears! Josh Jacobs, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Bears are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They had the fumble on the last drive, wound up leading to the opening touchdown. Now they'll try again here, first and 10. Michael Walker there to bring him down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
He dumps it to Eckler underneath. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. That one, a first down pickup of 8. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field. Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 4 catches for him in the wild card win a week ago, and he's got his first here, and it's a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
2 first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Up the middle with Eckler. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning it in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Once more, here's Eckler. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
On first down, it's gone. And Jones has it over the middle. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
11 yards there and a Lion first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. And I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Open man, that's Renfro. Touchdown! Hunter Renfro, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Lions are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Gano the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
It really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything's working pretty well for the defense.
What's going on the defensive side?
That's a tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
Straight ahead, it's Gainwell.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a Lion that's shaken up. So from the 36 now, first and 10. To throw, it's Allen. He finds his target, Beckham. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And that's going to bring up second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Oh, he's got some breathing room. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. First down for the Bears, a gain of 15. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Second down, Jacobs. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run-supported. I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
7-7, our score after one. This will be play number 7 on the drive, 3rd and 1 yard. And they'll try and run for it with Gainwell. They needed a yard, they got it, first down.
We ought to come up with a t-shirt and sell it that says, no indecision on 3rd and 1. And we didn't see it on that run, did we? Got his shoulders square, just got right into the line of scrimmage and picked it up.
Absolutely. Picked his lane, went with it, and converted. Here's Allen on 1st and 10. That pass complete to Moore. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. And they get the guard, John Runyon. They're backed up here with a 1st and 20 now after the holding penalty. Allen now looks to throw. This will be caught. It's Samuel. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And as a quarterback, you always want to exploit gaps in the defense. And he finds one here. Crossing route, working from right to left across the field. And once you get defenders going in the wrong direction, it is awfully hard for them to pivot back. And you end up getting the first down.
Jacobs going to try the middle, and he is going to lose yardage here. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stump that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
On second and 12, Allen over the middle to Beckham. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those over-reliable plays, because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw there.
And those guys like it, right? They can get the ball with a full head of steam.
Especially against man coverage, because man coverage, they're typically running away from someone and not worried about traffic coming out on the other end.
Completes it to Samuel. And he's brought down. A little surprise pass off on third and one. Pass and stop run. Gets him 15 yards.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not hold up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball across the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And we're going to get another timeout called by the Lions. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Motion left, the tight end. Jacobs again. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Josh Jacobs with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Bears have moved out in front. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the second time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack, and you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line, and he's able to take it into the end zone.
Tucker with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch. And it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps. You need a score here not just to follow the momentum from your last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Here's Goff. He'll get this out wide to Eckler. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it can turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
He appears to be about 2 feet short on third and three. Leaves him with a fourth and one.
Specifically, linebackers keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And boy, is he close. Did he get there?
field will have a challenge forthcoming. Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. On the handoff, this is Jacobs. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Once again, it's Jacobs. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Throwing is Allen on 3rd. Got his target, Samuel. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
I don't think anyone would argue that having that extra week definitely helps come playoff time. And those were some fresh legs right there. That extra practice time and planning, certainly in evidence.
They scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. Jacobs. Power on power, but he's not going to get in. Call it no gain, and it's going to be 2nd and goal. So stop from the 2, now
you know him pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Another shot from the 1 on 2nd and goal. They'll try again. And good work there defensively as they're able to keep him out of the end zone. The 2nd down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there.
That didn't just feel like good defense there, that felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a 3rd time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. A big one coming in this divisional round playoff, 3rd and goal. They'll run it with Jacobs, and he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Josh Jacobs. Saving his best for the playoffs with his 3rd touchdown of the game. And the Bears have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And it's now 21-7. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it 1st and 10. Crossing route, and he's got his man. It's Renfro. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
When you struggle on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards that half.
And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball through, and it's second down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Pressure, and he's taken down. A big sack. So now following the sack, Goff and the Lions needing to come up with something here on third and long. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Call. Trying to fight his tight end, Kelsey, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Steven Nelson. And the Bears are going to take possession of the football. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
So after the INT, it's Allen. And he will find his man, Samuel. Touchdown, Bears! Curtis Samuel, 26 yards. And the Bears continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Tucker with the extra point. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Charles, you're down multiple scores, less than a minute left here, but with that deficit, they've got to try to at least work their way into field goal range to try to muster something out of this drive.
And I'm going to go ahead and date myself one more time, because I'm going to quote an old Smokey and the Bandit lyric. They've got a long way to go and a short time to get there, but they still have time to get it done. So I'm looking forward to watching them mount this drive and see if they can get some points out of it.
Goff on third down. He's got a man open. It's Hunter Renfrow. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. On first and 10, Goff. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
Well, it hasn't been a banner first half for the defense trying to cover him today. But they'll take that one right there, helping force that incompletion.
Again, Goff. Flush to his right. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
That's not the first time they've gone his way on this drive, and they were obviously keyed into him because they were there to help break that pass up.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Goff now to throw. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
This defense is certainly well aggressive in this game. The coverage has been tough. Just to forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up fourth down.
The final shot before break here, Goff. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. This is taken just shy of the 10. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they're in the position they expected to be in. They've got the lead, home crowd behind them, and they're looking toward making that next step in these playoffs.
And I think a key for them is to put together some good, long, extended drives. Work the run in a little more with that big offensive line. I'm not saying get away from throwing the football. That's still working. But if they run it more effectively, it may get even bigger plays in the passing game.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
All right, now let's get in that end zone.
We're rolling, fellas.
Here's Allen to throw it. And his throw is incomplete. Defensively, celebration time because they finally forced an incompletion. He was perfect throwing the ball to that point.
Yeah, but from his viewpoint, they didn't force the incompletion. He just missed. That's how hot he is right now, and that's how he wants to continue to throw the ball.
It's going to be caught by Samuel, and he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Got what they needed there. The drive continues with a 9-yard pickup. On first and 10, it's Gainwell, and just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. From midfield, here's Allen. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential. But when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
Third and 2, they're going to elect to throw with Allen. And this one is incomplete. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
To throw for it on fourth. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Bears tried it on fourth down, unable to convert. And this defense will take over right at midfield. Goff and this Lions offense set for a first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. He'll hand off here to Eckler. And he'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Justin Pugh, the left guard that time with a flag. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Goff. It's Kelce on the ground. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10. From the 50, it's gone. He dumps it to Eckler underneath. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
The defense was ready for the back to leak out and even had a second player waiting to double him up. If you're going to commit to doubling a back, you better prevent a completion, but give him credit. Extra determination, extra effort, turn it into a successful play.
There's gone. And that's knocked away and incomplete.
That's another stop. One of the league's best defenses, and so they bring it in again this week.
Throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete. The Lions turned away on fourth down, and the Bears will get the football back. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. On the ground is Jacobs to start the drive, and he's going to get it across the midfield stripe in the Lion territory. 49 yards for him on the ground now, and three touchdowns to go along with it.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. The heavy set out there. Three tight ends in the formation for 3rd and 3. Allen gonna throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he will have the Bears first down, and he was able to get it by plenty. A gain of 8 on 3rd and 3.
They brought in a heavy set on 3rd down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen him throw out of that formation. And sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one. Wound up hitting him for a 1st down.
So 1st and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. They run behind center with Gainwell. And he'll bring this one inside the 35. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on 1st down, that fits the bill.
To the ground, this time Jacobs. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a 1st down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Here's Allen on 1st and 10. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys, we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the 1st tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
running straight ahead is Jacobs. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. 4 yards the pick up, first down.
Well, this has been a long drive, and Doc's seen up a good chunk of the third quarter, which is precisely what you want when you're playing with the lead. You control the football, you control the clock, and impose your will on the defense.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the gun, a give to Gainwell. And he's heating up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard, down to the 16.
They're taking a spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves and start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here and maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
1 quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Goff now looking to throw. He'll get this to Eckler, and he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
With this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
But we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline, because he certainly wants them to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, Goff. The tight end Kelsey has it over the middle. And they're going to get this down inside the 15. So 5 plays on this drive, Charles. All passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
And this is going to be intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it. And the Bears are going to take over at their own 11-yard line. Well, just another reason to celebrate there on the defensive side with the interception, and this is a game that they clearly have firmly in their grasp.
Yeah, a lot of handshakes, a lot of hugs, a lot of smiles. It's been their day.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Here's Allen. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. It got his man complete. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Chicago. As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all three phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one? You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, are they going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review. And it's no good. Oh, he misses the extra point, and our score stays right where it is. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. Goff's throw pulled in by Renfro. So the completion results there in 9 yards, and that'll give them a short yardage situation here for second down. Now Goff. That's into the hands of Eckler. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. A shotgun snap for Goff. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack.
So they'll accept that penalty, and that'll, of course, move the football up the field.
Now Goff on first down. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
And yet again, Goff is intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And they will score a pick six for the Bears' touchdown.
Well, this one was already ugly, and now it's just kind of becoming a feast on the defensive side of the football.
Yeah, partner, this is a unit that knows they've got this game in the bag with this huge lead, and it's going to drive their coaches crazy because they're telling them, play it straight, do all the right things. But these guys are going to be freewheeling now. All of them are going to take chances, and that one pays off with an INT and a return for six.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone.
And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And, Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things through this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers
you would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next?
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Teron Johnson able to pick it. And the Bears are going to take possession here as they've got it at their own four-yard line. Another great play defensively. They've been sharp on both sides of the ball, Charles, but that interception means that this defense very well keep them down to single digits on the scoreboard in this game.
And that's something to smile about, isn't it, partner, if you're on defense? Because your goal every game is to pitch a shutout, but you and I both know that's pretty unrealistic. But to hold a team below double figures in a game, in an NFL game, that's certainly something to take pride in.
Second down at five. Here's a handoff to Jacobs. And not much there at all as he'll get this only up to about the 11. Well, trailing here in the fourth quarter, and that personal foul, that only adds to the hole that they're currently standing in.
Yeah, absolutely a bad job of just losing your cool and letting your anger take over. Mistakes like that, not going to help you at this stage of the game.
73 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where the extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Straight ahead, it's Gainwell. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Throwing now is Allen. It's caught. Beckham. Calling a gain of three on the play. And it'll be third down. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. The offense on third down tonight, they've hit on six of their eight tries. Very good. This time it's third and three. And he'll be tackled about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A one-yard pickup leads to fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
And maybe some indecision on what to do, and they're going to get a delay. Here's A.J. Cole now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. Now a high kick, almost a pooch punt. Just a 25-yard punt, not what he was hoping for by any stretch. And the Lions are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. Goff and this Lions offense set for a first and 10 at their own 13. And the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
He's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'm guaranteed quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back in his own 40-yard line. Trey Hendrickson, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of nine.
Talk about two sides of the ball across purposes, because mercifully this game's almost over for the offense, but the defense, they still want to get a few shots in. That front seven, they've loved this ball game. They've been able to pad their stats, and maybe some backups can get in and get a sack as well.
Well, shot taken on third down, but it's going to end up being
good. They always think about picking up the first down. In this case, they were thinking about something bigger. They were thinking about the home run shot and took it downfield. Unable to connect, but admire the effort.
Here's Johnny Hacker now, and no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And he'll try and hurry the kick, gets it away, but it's not looking that great. Following the punt return here, there is someone shaken up. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now a carry for Jacobs. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. On the tackle, it was the West Virginia man, Kaiser White.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
And now here comes the third of their timeouts defensively. So they'll be left with only the two-minute warning to stop it from here on out. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. To throw, it's Allen. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. To the air, Allen. Completes it to Samuel. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. And the tight end goes in motion left. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. A lot of points have been scored in this game against them, but tally that one on the side of the defense.
Do you think maybe, possibly, it could be a little bit of a changer for them? Maybe not a game changer, but a little bit of a momentum one that maybe they can string together some pretty good plays and slow them down.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. The win for the Bears just around the corner. They go down to a knee. Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. They go down to a knee, and with that, they're off to the NFC title game. So this offense, which was humming all game, ends on a negative play. We didn't see many of those as he takes the knee, but what an explosion and a good win.
Can we call it a negative positive play?
There you go.
Okay, an oxymoron to end the ball game.
And they can watch the clock go down and celebrate the victory. say so long, everybody.